morning, everybody. General Salaria, Commandant School of Army, and our respected host for this seminar. Respected senior officers, representatives of industries, and my dear gunners, it is my proud privilege to stand here again on this podium in this seminar of St. Joe's and given an opportunity to give this presentation. Let me tell you, I am an old horse. This is my 10th visit to RD school. 2010, I came here first and spoke from this very podium about concept of Dhanush. 2010. And today, it is 2020. In St. Joe's seminar also, I think RT Technology Seminar initially was being organized by RT Directorate and taken over by St. Joe's. I have been speaking in each of the seminars. And journey to this RT school and speaking is just like a pilgrimage for me, where I get to interact with such huge talent of officers and many of the bright ideas I have got here while interacting with the student officers. I have been taking classes in the LGSE also initially. Of late I have not been taking, but the curiosity and the wisdom displayed by officers and their knowledge of technology has always amazed me. We have been always hearing about Dhanush. So this time I thought, what is new which I can bring in my presentation? It was a difficult decision. Then I thought that many of the participating officers probably will be for the first time hearing about Dhanush. So this presentation of mine is mix of the basic Dhanush characteristics, and I have given a title, Lessons and Experience in the Journey of Dhanush. My presentation will be like this. I will talk very briefly about OFB, although nothing new to tell about. Background of artillery gun development in our country. OFB and Indian artillery. People are worried about numbers. 155 is going to be the caliber of future. So, definitely the infrastructure at OFB for large caliber gun system. About Dhanush, I will talk about some basic specifications, not much. Configuration and milestones. Most of the time I would like to devote on qualification and testing. How to do the qualification of the design and testing of the gun system and the lessons which we have acquired or gained in the arduous journey of Dhanush. Brief introduction of OFB. Producing defense equipment for over 200 years, 1801 was the year when we came into existence. Over 600 products, 41 factories, over 80,000 employees. It is largest conglomerate having multitude of technologies under one roof, heavily backward integrated. Product range, right from tents to tanks, from chemicals to explosives, weapon from 0.22 caliber to 155 caliber, complete ammunition system, hardware, fitting, fuses. As our chairman has said, we have been trying our hand in R&D. We have 42 ordnance development centers. Each of our factories have a development center now. Till 1 year back, we had only 12 ordnance development centers. Today, we have ordnance development centers at all the factories, and ordnance factory Medak has got two. So that is how 42 ordnance development centers. We have over 100 well-qualified Grenfell University trained officers who are trained in military vehicles, gun system, ammunition system, guided missiles, military electronics, working in ordnance development centers. And as an organization, we are transforming from only a producer to system developer. But let me say, not in isolation. Wherever it is required, we are taking along the DRDO help and also help of the industry for developing and qualifying and testing our systems. Regarding OFB infrastructure for large gun system, we have everything, right from metallurgy. Metallurgy is one thing which I have found army fraternity largely worried. But let me tell you, the metallurgical processes and the steel which we are producing is probably the best in the world, or comparable to the best in the world. We have everything so far as technology is concerned: arc furnaces, LFPD, ESR, we have forging presses, and we have a special machine, radial forging plant, in which hollow forging of barrels can be done in one stroke. So far as the machining process is concerned, we have everything: deep hole drilling, rifling machines, huge machining centers, universal milling, auto fretage, alignment lathes. Think about it, of any technology, it is with us. And Ordnance Factory Board probably has today the largest barrel manufacturing capability in the world. Over 600 barrels we can produce large caliber in a year. Let me talk a little about the background of artillery development. Underlying fact, no need to tell again, that self-designed guns are mainstay of many nations. Most of the nations, in fact. But in our country, the effort has been limited so far as development of indigenous gun systems are concerned till 1985. General Kudayar, General Chandan was talking about, was probably the first gun development team which was put together in our country and which came out with IFG and then LFG. One more gun they had made, which was lighter LFG, which did not come into use. But that gun was also developed by that gun. But at that point of time, our country decided to move in for 155mm gun systems. And in 155, the Bofors technology was taken, and it was in this sense that from 105 to 155 will jump and bridge the gap of technology with the help of the technological transfer but unfortunately that could not happen. Then we were making 105 all over the Europe and the world. People were working for 155mm gun system and they were going for automatic guns, hydraulic drives and electro-optical sighting system. But we had not reached to that stage. Unfortunately, gun development team was disbanded in 1980s and the gun development effort in our country ceased. DOT of Bofors was not transferred fully, so we remained at standstill so far as technological development in the country is concerned. However, at OFB we started our in-house R&D efforts to develop 155 guns in 1993. Our first barrel was produced in 1993, which is called Mark 1. And we put it on 130mm chassis, the first upgun sort of thing. And that has fired over 30,000 rounds at PNC bars. That is the workhorse of PNC Balasore for the putting of all ammunition system. Unfortunately, there were some lacuna and some deficiencies in the gun, so we could not induct that gun in the service. We opted for Soltan later on. Now, Project Dhanush had its seeds when the Indian Army decided to upgrade Bofors to 155-45 and equip it with electronic sighting system in around 2003-2004. This GSQR was made and this gave us a fillip to start thinking of developing 155-45 gun system, and we thought of taking it as an upgradation program so far as over the Bofors. And we started working on this and we designed the barrel. Let me tell you a small anecdote on this. We took a gun sir from PXC Balasore. They had two guns, so one gun we took, it was almost junk. Took it to 506 workshop, base workshop. Got it overhauled, designed a barrel, proof-fired it, put it on the gun, and we very happily took it to PXC Balasore for firing. We took it to the firing bay. Just after the gun was positioned, we started the engine, the power pack fell. Huge disappointment. But we did not get disappointed. We came back again. Within 2 months after setting these things all right, and we started firing again. And after every third round, there used to be a failure. But still, we did not accept it. We kept our effort. Those were the days when we selected the main slot muzzle brake, so far as integrated with the barrel to be used. But when we were trying out main slot muzzle brake, we found that it was not, when the shell was traveling through the main slot muzzle brake, it was leaving few marks. So, main slot muzzle brake was sort of not accepted, and we designed a new muzzle brake, which is modified double baffle muzzle brake, higher efficiency muzzle brake, which became the turning point for Project Dhanush. Because without a higher efficiency muzzle brake, the same structure cannot be used. OFB and Indian Artillery, we have special relationships dating back to more than two centuries. We are the largest manufacturers of the all indigenous gun systems till now. I hope that Indian industry will be supplying guns and which will be more part of Indian Artillery and Indian Army. We provide lifetime support to the gun system. We are at the forefront of development of modern indigenous artillery gun system, Dhanush and Sharan. They are two latest examples. We have supplied more than 5,000 pieces of artillery to Indian Army. So far as Sharang is concerned, a little, it is 100% indigenous solution, Afghani. It has been extensively evaluated during various trials, and induction is going to take place shortly. We have been talking about consistency and accuracy. During the trials, it has given exceptional performance so far as accuracy and consistency is concerned. 0.8% range and 0.2% is in line. At 80% of the maximum range is the acceptance criteria. And our gun was giving 0.2% in range and 0.1% in line. So several 100% times better than the specifications. And the reason and the behind this to give such high accuracy and consistency barrel goes to our manufacturing technology. We make our barrel differently, which is giving, and similar sort of consistency we are getting in Dhanush gun also. We are getting routinely 0.3% in range at 80% of the maximum range, around 22 kilometers, and 0.1% in line, which is one, due to the manufacturing techniques, and second, due to the laying system accuracy which we have improved by putting INS on the gun system and the fire control system. Again, the path breaking model. I will tell you this story about Dhanush beginning. 2008, we put together this gun and we wanted to fire 38 kilometers to test its maximum range. Sir, it took us 8 months effort to fire 8 rounds at Kobra. 8 months we corresponded with RT Directorate and other Pokhara and other agencies. We could not take our gun and fire and test its maximum. 8 months of effort, and in 2008, for the first time, we fired our gun and tested its range. So RT has been with us throughout thereafter, once they realize our potential. You can see the generations of DGRTs, they are standing behind them. And the tradition is continuing. Just previous DGRT, General Shabastov and General Salaria, they have also been with us always wholeheartedly. So far as Dhanush is concerned, people call it Desi Bofors. I feel very hurt when people call it Desi Bofors. Even in Republic Day parade, people called it Desi Bofors. But honestly, it is not Bofors. So much of difference is there. It looks like Bofors, but much better in range, much better in laying system, much better sighting system, onboard the ballistic calculation, gun recording, 1/10 of the conventional time of gun recording we can achieve with our INS-based sighting system, and this has been demonstrated during the trials. So far as barrel is concerned, it is longer, around 7 meters long, and the Bofors was around 6 meters long. But the major difference is the chamber volume, which is 23 liters. General Channan was talking about the standardization. So this 23 liter chamber volume is the JB MOU combined chamber volume. Joint Ballistic Memorandum of Understanding. So all the countries, NATO countries, use 23 liter chamber volume so that uniformity of ammunition can be maintained. We chose 23 liter chamber volume so that standardization is maintained. Contemporary features, 45 caliber barrels, new loading truck for BMCS, which can take back charges also, high efficiency muzzle brake. So far as electronic systems are concerned, muzzle velocity radar, inertial navigation system, gun control computer. Aim of the electronic sighting system, auto lane, muzzle velocity feedback for better accuracy, improved sighting system, compatibility with projection, it has been demonstrated. Inertial navigation system, it gives tremendous advantage so far as positioning and laying is concerned. But I will tell you another story. We started with an analog version of INS, sir. Generally, in our trials, we fire around 200 trials and 250 rounds and qualify a gun system, a foreign gun system or any gun system. But after firing around 1,500 rounds, we realized that this INS analog version is no good for this level of vibration. So midway the trial, we switched over from this analog version to digital version, and that gave us very rich dividends. Now all Dhanush will have digital INS Sigma 30D. Muzzle velocity radar, better feedback. This data I will keep so that this gives some technological technology behind FDR also, so that the young officers and the gunners are benefited. Advanced gun sighting system. This is for night firing and day firing, direct firing engagement. Backup sight, which was a requirement of GSQ. Backup sight, although it looks very simple, sir, we tried to select a backup sight, and in country we had only one 104 sight, IMG sight, which was degree minute sight, and requirement was to convert it into 6400 NATO bill sight. So we converted, and we thought that we have won the war. We put it on the guns. When we started initially comparing this system with INS, there was difference of 87 mils. Then we realized that we do not understand the geometry, 3D geometry of the sighting system. It was very difficult, sir. I came to school of RT to understand this. Still, we could not solve it. So we put two persons who studied sighting system for 3 months and found out the problem, what our mistake which we are doing, and then we corrected it, and now it is giving 1 mil accuracy. So all this has been process of learning and learning together. One officer, I am forgetting the name, I came here, he gave me idea of, he drew some diagrams of the sighting system. We went back, put two officers, and then got the results. Loading truck, again a very simple system, sir, but qualification takes a lot of time. Generally, sir, for different phases of any project, it is like concept and QR, design validation, prototype building, test and trials, evaluation, and mass production, different phases. Concept and QR is very important, sir, very, very important. I would like to bring it again, sir. When the this upgradation of Bofors was planned, QRs were made and it failed, means that could not see the light of day, the day. One reason of this was incorrect QR. Generally the rate of laying of Bofors is 1 to 1.5 degree per second. In the QR, when we were upgrading, only changing the barrel and putting the electronic sighting system, the rate of laying in the QR was 8 to 10 degree per second, which is unachievable, because we are just upgrading the gun. 8 to 10 degree was not required. Everybody said yes, only we said no, it is not possible. And we proved that it is not possible. Later on, project was could not take off, but Dhanush took off. Design part is easy, but design validation is again a very difficult proposition. Modeling, everybody does, analysis everybody does, but whether your models are correct, analysis is correct, this qualification requires different set of skills, which we learned, what mistakes we commit. We committed several mistakes, but now we are much better off. Test and trials. We have really evolved for qualification and testing of one system along with Dhanush. And one reason why we are successful and this is why this is improved system is that it has been evaluated by a number of units. A lot of heads have seen the system, suggested improvements, and OFB and WDET, they are always open for suggestions. We never took any suggestion lightly. We never said that this is not possible without proper analysis. So far as barrel is concerned, you will be very happy to know, sir, that metallurgy. We have supplied 2 barrels to Bofors Test Center, 155-52, before we have given to Indian Army. And they are using it as pressure barrel for qualification of European ammunition system. And I just got a feedback, I was sharing with one of the officers, that this barrel has crossed first quarter and second quarter, and its performance is, if not less, as good as the European companies and US barrels which is being made for water. We are using barrels of it. Require level stability was thoroughly studied. I will just show you how these things are done, but not in detail. Structural adequacy, again, this steel which is used in the structure is a microalloy steel. Microalloy steel gives highest fracture toughness at lower temperature, which was the part of the Dhanush. So it was not available in our country. So SAIL especially came forward and developed this microalloy steel, with which his complete structures were made. Mother brick is modified, higher efficiency mother brick with greater rifle area, so that 155-39 carriage can be utilized. Again, General was talking about modular systems. And we have tried to make this system as much as possible modular. So same system can be put on, say, a mounted gun system. Same systems can be put on SP gun, similar, not all. So that modularity, logistic advantage is there. Qualification and testing, the lessons. We initially, it was a new concept. PSQL was made, and we did not know. DSE approval was also given, and then we did not know we are going to go for 155-45 mechanical system or electronic system. So it was open, and PSQLs were made accordingly. So first testing which we did was to select whether we want mechanical system or electronic system. Again, a path breaking which was not thought of earlier. In the journey of Dhanush, we made 12 prototypes. Just details are mentioned. It is the most exploited and widely evaluated gun system, setting very high standards. Indigenization, more than 81%, and with the new power pack, it will be around 90%. New power pack, although it looks new, but even Bofors, I have seen up to 100, the changes were made in Bofors one, and whatever changes were there, it was implemented in all the guns, earlier guns also, which were supplied. So we should not worry about improvements. We will implement it in all the guns so that uniformity is maintained for the logistic and maintenance. More than 4,500 rounds, to be precise, 4,599 rounds have been fired till date. Its consistency better than all contemporary guns. Can I have the video, please? Accuracy at high altitude. We went to Siachen base camp. Can I have the video, please? Please play the link. Click on the link. Click on the link. Accuracy, yes. This is the firing that is direct indirect shoot. Although this capability has been demonstrated at RT school Devlali also. It was direct indirect shoot being attempted around 5.5 kilometers and 3 rounds were fired. You will see how nicely and closely the 3 rounds. Internal firings are separate. Every month we used to have event. We used to go to some proof range and fire. Winter firing trials, summer firing trials, GCQ evaluation, they also fired. Confirmatory trials, MET, EMIMC, it took maximum time. Again, we faltered here. We did not understand the technology. Then we almost spent 2 years to get EMIMC clear for the Dhanush. Confirmatory trials. Again a new concept, because 200 rounds I don't feel the gun system can be tested. So we offered and RT graciously accepted to try out 6 guns, 3 guns in deserts, 3 guns in high altitudes, then all 6 guns firing together as battery. And there was a, again sir, RT school suggested, let us test either all gun shoots together. Means as a battery can be engaged single target with the 6 guns. This was also tested, sir, in user exploitation, and this capability was also demonstrated. Again, up detection, we fired 141 rounds to qualify and select this 155-45 electronic upgradation. Prototype production, just a slide, this much stage we covered. Maximum rounds we fired at highest drone. User exploitation, as our chairman has also mentioned, he has given us a lot of good ideas. Over 160 suggestions were put forward. Of over 100 we have implemented. User also got to know and got to experience of using the high technology gun systems in the vision scenario. We also understood the views of the user very well. So far as maintenance aspect is concerned, once we do this Dhanush, indigenization of Bofors spares will also be very easy. I remember hydraulic system, when we wanted for the first prototype, we tried to import. The quotation was 12 crores for the hydraulic system. And we got it developed in our country at 1.3 crore. Similarly, power pack was offered to us at 5 crore rupees. We now producing power pack around 1.5 crore, and if we recognize further, it will be under 1 crore. So this is going to help a complete ecosystem. It's a great learning experience, Dhanush, so far as OFB is concerned. So project execution, modeling technical skills, defect investigation. We had 2-3 accidents in Dhanush. But all those accidents gave us brilliant insight into gun technology. The things which we are not doing earlier, we started. Dhanush, we call it trailblazer in real sense. It has reaffirmed the belief in the country that our country can be self-sufficient and self-reliant for development of and production of the state-of-art battlefield equipment. I remember 2006, for the first time we showcased Bofors upgrade in Def Expo. It was the only one gun in the country of its type, and today in Def Expo, and even when you go outside, you see so many guns standing. So this confidence to produce the new guns, the Dhanush project has given to the entire country. And some of the credit we would like to take away. I would like to take questions if there are any on any aspects of this project. Our chairman has also talked about it. Preserving national resources. So we suggest to devise a mechanism where the duplicity of efforts is avoided. If we have capability to produce, why to have similar system in private sector? It's a national risk. The structure may be placed to identify inclusive technology. It was told that 60 to 80% is low to medium technology gun, which is required in war machines. So 20% can be also attempted to be developed. 80% we can have also. Collaborative approach can be taken, and result will be expansion of defense industrial base in the country, and help make the Indian defense sector highly competitive and cost-effective. Let us work together to provide Indian artillery the modern state-of-art weapon systems indigenously. Thank you very much.